A number of households in Kenya depend on firewood and charcoal in preparation of meals. Many have had to endure a long journey in search of this commodity. In some parts of the country, firewood and charcoal are affordable and easily available. But its negative impact to the environment is often ignored. Kakuma refugee camp lies in a semi-arid region in the northwestern part of the country in Turkana County. Finding firewood is a tall order for many here. According to officials from the World Food Program, some of the women and girls who venture out of the camp in search of firewood have been attacked.
Sometimes they face sexual and gender-based violence. They are attacked there. They face snake bites or scorpion stings.
But hopefully in a short while, this narrative will change for the better. A new and cleaner mode of cooking has been introduced here, solar cookers. The scorching heat provides the energy to fuel the cookers, eliminating the need for firewood or charcoal, and alongside it, the harmful effects on the environment. Based on their design, they are easily assembled and portable too. About 500 children from Kakuma are now learning how to handle and use the solar cookers. The temperature today is about 32 degrees Celsius. The kitchen under the sun is ready to cook a variety of meals. Deborah Bahati from Congo is among the participants who turned up for the solar cooking festival. She, like the rest of the children, is preparing noodles. Faustine Odaba, popularly known as Mama Sola, is the head of the kitchen under the sun. Her duty is to ensure that the cookers are well assembled and every child is comfortable using it.
Solar cooking is cooked while it's covered. Most of the fresh foods we don't add in water. They cook in their own natural flavor. But if you are using normal fire, you have to add lots of water. It saves on fuel costs. It's one cooker that you don't have to be there. It cooks while you are away. You don't have to attend to the food.
You might be wondering, what is the magic behind the solar cooker? Because we don't have a physical fire and there is no matchbox in use. But for starters, we need a sufuria and a pan and a lid that is coated black that helps in the absorption of heat from the sun. Now, the solar cooker has been designed in such a way that the rays from the sun are directed in the middle, which is the focal point where the sufuria is placed, and the heat in turn cooks the food inside.
The inside part of the solar cookers are all bright. They are like they have mirrors. We are using the reflective aluminium inside the mirror. Why? Because we need something that is very reflective, and it has been made in a way that when the rays fall on the cooker, they are reflected back. And when they reflect back, as we know scientifically, light travels on a straight line. And where all the rays converge is where we have the black pot. Ugale.
Wow. The solar is not limited to the number of meals it can cook. Solar cookers fall in the category of clean energy.
You can imagine over 500 cookers have been cooking here, yet there is no smoke that has actually been going into the ozone layer.
The conservation of the environment, because it reduces the cutting of trees.
In 2015, during Paris climate deal talks, governments all over the world committed to a universal agreement to cut greenhouse gas emissions to avoid effects of climate change. About 200 countries signed the deal, which aims at setting a new goal to reach net zero emissions in the second half of the century. The deal targets the building of a clean energy economy. This places Kakuma refugee camp as a model in Kenya, the whole of East Africa and the continent, which if emulated then, achieving the goals from the Paris talks will be easy. The solar cookers project at Kakuma refugee camp is a brainchild of Godfrey Mawira from World Food Program, National Council of Churches of Kenya, San Diego Rotary in the US and Simplified for Life from India.
Wow, the cake is ready.
Sharon Baranga, NTV, in Kakuma refugee camp, Turkana County.